sure if they're up here now, but are there any children from some? There are here. They're already here. All right. So any children who'd like a better seat, I invite you to come on forward. So you can see the baptism close up. Great. How are you all today? Good. There's plenty of room over on this side, too, if anybody wants to sit over on this side. All right. It's good to see you all. So we've been talking a whole lot about water today. And what does water have to do with baptism? We pour water on your head. We do. To bless you. Absolutely, absolutely. And do you know who else was baptized with water by John the Baptist? Jesus. Mm-hmm. And when he was baptized, do you know where he was baptized? We need water to get a drink. You're right, we do. We need water for life, too, which is another important reason. But Jesus was baptized in the River Jordan, and when he was baptized, God said, "This is my child, my beloved, with whom I am well pleased." And when we baptize, we remind ourselves that we are God's beloved, and that this beautiful baby, Charles right here, is God's beloved. So we are going to celebrate that. That's worth celebrating, don't you think? All right. So are we ready to celebrate?
Yeah.
All right. The candidate for holy baptism will now be presented. Will you be responsible for seeing that the child you present is brought up in the Christian faith and life?
I will, with God's help.
Will you, by your prayers and witness, help this child to grow into the full stature of Christ?
I will, with God's help.
Do you renounce Satan and all the spiritual forces of wickedness that rebel against God?
I renounce them.
Do you renounce the evil powers of this world which corrupt and destroy the creatures of God?
I renounce them.
You renounce all sinful desires that draw you from the love of God.
I renounce them.
Do you turn to Jesus Christ and accept him as your Savior?
I do.
Do you put your whole trust in his grace and love?
I do.
Do you promise to follow and obey him as your Lord?
I do.
And to all of you, will you who witness these vows do all in your power to support this person in his life in Christ?
We will.
Let us join with him who is committing himself to Christ and renew our own baptismal covenant. Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, the only Son of our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of our Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Will you continue in the apostles' teaching and fellowship, in the breaking of bread and in the prayers?
I will, with God's help.
You persevere in resisting evil. And whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord.
I will, with God's help.
Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ?
I will, with God's help.
Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself?
I will, with God's help.
Will you strive for justice and peace among all people and respect the dignity of every human being?
I will, with God's help.
Let us now pray for this child who is to receive the sacrament of new birth.
Deliver him, O Lord, from the way of sin and death.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Open his heart to your grace and truth.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Fill him with your holy and life-giving spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Keep him in the faith and communion of your holy church.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Teach him to love others in the power of the Spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Send him into the world and witness to your love.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Bring him to the fullness of your peace and glory.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Grant, O Lord, that all who are baptized into the death of Jesus Christ, your Son, may live in the power of his resurrection. And look for him to come again in glory, who lives and reigns now and forever.
Amen.
I bet you all come forward. Anna, would you do me a favor? Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
Thank you, Almighty God, for the gift of water. Over it, the Holy Spirit moved in the beginning of creation. Through it, you led the children of Israel out of their bondage in Egypt and into the land of promise. In it, your Son Jesus received the baptism of John and was anointed by the Holy Spirit as the Messiah, the Christ, to lead us through his death and resurrection from the bondage of sin into everlasting life. We thank you, Father, for the water of baptism. In it we are buried with Christ in his death. By it we share in his resurrection. Through it we are reborn by the Holy Spirit. Therefore, in joyful obedience to your Son, we bring into his fellowship those who come to him in faith, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Now sanctify this water, we pray you, by the power of your Holy Spirit, that those who here are cleansed from sin and born again may continue forever in the risen life of Jesus Christ our Savior. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit, be all honor and glory, now and forever.
Amen.
Charles, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Charles, sealed by the power of the Holy Spirit and marked as Christ's own forever.
Amen.
Amen. Charles, receive the light of Christ.
Amen.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you that by water and the Holy Spirit you have bestowed upon this, your servant, the forgiveness of sin, and have raised him to new life of grace. Sustain him, O Lord, in your Holy Spirit. Give him an inquiring and discerning heart, the courage to will and to persevere, and a spirit to know and to love you, and the gift of joy and wonder in all your works.
Amen.
Let us welcome the newly baptized.
We receive you into the household of God, confess the faith of Christ crucified, proclaim his resurrection, and share with us his eternal existence.
Welcome.
peace of Christ be always with you.
And also with you.